The district recently released its 2024 seagrass mapping results on what we call the Suncoast, which is Tampa Bay to Charlotte Harbor. We saw some big gains in Sarasota Bay, about 19%. In Sarasota Bay proper, we saw as much as 24% gain in seagrass compared to the last time we mapped, which was in 2022. I'm Dr. Chris Anastasiou, Chief Water Quality Scientist and Seagrass Mapping Program Lead for the Southwest Florida Water Management District. In Sarasota Bay, we mapped almost 12,000 acres of seagrass, which is up well over 1,500 acres from 2022. In Tampa Bay, we mapped a little over 31,000 acres, which is up about 1,500 acres from the 2022 numbers, and that overall represents a 5% gain in seagrass in Tampa Bay. One of the largest bay segments that saw an increase was Hillsborough Bay. We saw about 185% increase in seagrass between 2022 and 2024. The Water Management District has been mapping seagrasses since 1988. Seagrass are a very important part of the overall health of our estuaries. In fact, they're a great indicator of health. There's essentially three phases to creating a seagrass map for us. The first is acquisition. We have fixed wing aircraft that fly at about 9,000 feet, collect high resolution digital imagery that is specifically for the purpose of mapping seagrass. The second is photo interpretation, which is creating the map based on the image signature. And then the third, which is just as important as the first two, is field verification. We go out, our district scientists, along with our contractors, will go out and we will collect information in water using video so that we have that imagery cataloged, and then we will compare what we see in the field with what the image signature is showing the photo interpreters. While overall the news is pretty good, there are areas that have had and continue to have issues. One area is Charlotte Harbor. Charlotte Harbor saw a significant loss of seagrass from 2018, really until this most recent mapping cycle. And part of the reason for that, we think, was initially the large red tide event that occurred in 2017 and to 18 and part of 19. Another area that saw loss was Old Tampa Bay. This bay segment in Tampa Bay continues to struggle. We lost about 5% of our seagrass between 2022 and 2024, and that comes off of about a 40% loss from 2018. Our seagrass maps are used to track long-term change in our estuaries, and so when we see places like Old Tampa Bay, it helps drive resource management, not only at the district, but also with our resource management partners like the estuary program, local governments, to take action. Even though these areas that have seen big gains are areas that we're very encouraged by, it doesn't mean that we can lessen our effort to protect and, where possible, improve water quality and the overall state of these bays and estuaries. If the seagrass are doing well, then overall, the estuary is doing well.